Okay, today we'll see the transient thermal conductivity using ANSYS. Now here is one problem: having one rectangular plate dimension 1 meter by 1 meter. At the top edge you can see the temperature here 600 degrees Celsius and the bottom edge 200 degrees Celsius. This is the boundary condition. Then some material properties also mentioned in the problem, like thermal conductivity of material 10 watt meter Kelvin. Then assume the block is infinitely long. Material density is 980 kg per meter cube and the specific heat capacity is 2.08. Now what is basically transient heat conduction? It means transient means temperature variation with respect to time. Now we'll solve this using ANSYS. Now how to solve? First open the ANSYS, then similar to the previous thermal analysis, click on the preferences, here thermal you have to select, then OK, preprocessor, element type, add, edit, delete, add. For thermal analysis you have to choose the COD 4 node 55, apply, close. Then material properties mentioned in the problem, material model, thermal conductivity is given 10, so apply there 10 value. Then specific heat is also mentioned, which is 2.08, and density is 780. Okay, so once you apply the material property, you have to model this. Modeling, create, area, rectangle by two corners. Here xy value is initial point, will not give. Width and height is 1 1. Okay, then once you create this, we have to mesh this model. So for meshing, go to meshing, mesh tool, or size control. Here we'll apply the same size for manual size, area, all area, and edge length will give 0.05. okay, then next is your solution. Analysis type, new analysis. Here we have to apply the transient analysis, which will the temperature will change with respect to time, so transient. Okay, then here's two options: mode superposition or full. So we'll select the full, and lumped mass approximation. Okay, then solution control. Here some basic change we have to make. First is, here we have to give the time step. At end we'll give 300 time steps. Then sub steps, for every time step suppose 25, total number 200, and then maximum minimum number of time steps 25. Another one value you have to change, that for n is equal to 1, with every n step you have to calculate. Then go to this option, non-linear. Click on the non-linear, check here on, and program chosen, and here you have to give the maximum number of iterations, which is 100. So these two basic change you have to check, then OK. Then define load, apply thermal temperature on node. Okay, the previous, actually the meshing is left, so first mesh this. Already you have set the mesh criteria, so go to just mesh tool and mesh. Okay, apply. Then go to solution, same step, define load, apply temperature on node, and here instead of this single, click on the box and select the box here like this, because on the top total nodes you have to apply the temperature 500 degrees Celsius. So temperature 500. Okay, similar way we have to apply the temperature boundary condition on the bottom, so select from here. Instead of this you have to select the box, so select from here. Okay, so this way you have to apply only on the bottom edge. Then apply, here temperature is 100 degrees Celsius. Okay, so now you can see this boundary conditions. Once you apply the boundary condition, then here is another option, that is initial condition. So initial condition, list all, sorry, initial condition, define, and here you have to check pick all, and here you can give the initial value of degree of freedom 100, okay, or 200. Then next is solve current LS, okay. Then solution is done, so everything is right. Then you have to check the post processing, plot result, contour plot, nodal solution, DOF solution, nodal temperature, okay. Here you can see the temperature variation from 500 to 100. Actually it is 200, so just check that condition whenever you are applying. And if you want to check the animation with respect to time, the animate results over a time, and here you can change the value, time range, here you can give the time frame 10, 20, DOF solution, temperature, and okay. Okay, so here you can see the time, for the time range you will get the solution. We will pass this. Okay, so here is the time variation, for every second you will give the temperature variation. So this way you have to complete transient thermal conduction analysis.